And right next to me is the guild president of IUIU, Islamic University of...
In Uganda.
I was going to say IUOU. But welcome to the show, guys. How are you doing? How is the debate? Let me start with you. How is IUIU? How do you find the debate? Do you feel like Chambogo University has, you know, hosted you right?
I'd like to start by thanking Chambogo University for hosting us in the East African Debate Championship. We have really had fun in Chambogo, and we hope to be here for many other events in the future, inshallah. We are being hosted well, and I feel like I'm comfortable and fine.
Now, let me come to you from Mass. Chambogo University is the defending champion for this challenge here, and they're hosting it this year round. What do young people, people from universities gain out of these debates that you host every now and then and have people from different universities coming to attend? What do you gain? Or is it just meeting friends and, you know, making people acquaintances here and there?
You know, first of all, this debate is majorly agitated by the entire University Council of East Africa, and it's just a method of fostering and upbringing the integration perspective. And now, first, tackling integration in terms of intellectuality of young minds. So that's the major first objective. And being the third debate and in the region, and Chambogo University is lucky to be the first host in the country, the power of Africa, we are very happy to be here, and we are just pleased that they have welcomed us well. We are just from up country to here, and we are really comfortable.
You're really happy.
Yeah, happy. Thank you very much.
Now, let me come to you. You're a lady. You're at Chambogo University. You've taken this championship twice, and you're hosting it for the very first time. How have you organized? How have you been a good host to these, you know, other universities that are coming through?
First and foremost, we had an organizing committee. We've always had press conferences to inform the public about what was going to happen. We've had good publicity, yes. And then for all the visitors, those that arrived, as we had planned, already had the programs of all the activities, and we had already organized their places of accommodation. So everything is going on well, and for the teams that have not yet come in, are set to come.
Ah, that's interesting. There are teams that haven't yet arrived.
Yes, those that come from far.
From far, like where? Zimbabwe? East Africa. Sorry, it's my bad. Now, let me come to you as guild president.
Yes,
this debate is in your university. What is the conversation around this whole 10 days that you're going to be here? What's the conversation in the youth? What are they saying?
Thank you so much, Urban TV and Vision Group. We are happy that you're among our sponsors. Thanks for the chance. We expect all the best. Our visas arrived yesterday, first, and it's going up to 9th. We have organized several events for them. We have movie nights, Rolex nights, as I told you. We have nights out as clubs. We are going to beach. So it's really something organized. And I'm sure everyone will have to enjoy.
All right, that's very interesting. Eric, I'm not going to ask you what you've organized for these guys in terms of Twitter and Facebook. But let me just take this minute to just say that the Bank of Uganda came through and said they are making losses in billions of shillings, you know, since the mobile money tax was put into effect. What's your thought on that? Ugandans are coming out to say that since Bank of Uganda is making losses, we should forget about the social media tax. And, you know, they are multiplying the losses by Ayan saying this tax is not taking us anywhere. What's your take on that whole Bank of Uganda thing?
First of all, I want to first critique the figures. I don't remember the figure they mentioned, but inflation has actually stepped up to about
672.
No. The inflation rate. I don't want to go in for that figure. That figure can be deceptive. The inflation rate is going up, and the government should realize one thing. The micros of the economies of scale can't be just played around with. Just because you think a tax is needed does not verify that it is good for the economy or good for the business world. And I'm happy to see that reflect today. So as these guys go on to debate about sustainable development, regional integration, I want them to focus on the way our economies can grow together, economies of Rwanda. Rwanda is growing at a faster rate than the other East African countries today, although Kenya is still the powerhouse, and Uganda, as we know it, but the rate of growth is really worrying. If we keep this way, in the next few years, you could hear another exit, as if the Brit exit is it's happening in the likes of Europe.
Now, let me come to you from Mbara University of Science and Technology. You spend a little over 9 months in Mbarara. It's a town out of the city center. How has this mobile money tax affected people in Mbarara?
You know, there is a principle of ignoring. You know, when you're bringing up a tax, and we understand governments need tax to operate and give out social services. But the minds that bring up the tax, you should be ready to know that I bring up this tax, people will be waiting to pay it, and it will be consolidated. But now, if you bring a tax that people will not pay, it will not be consolidated, it means the project will not be success. And now what happens is, people are getting used more and used to deal away with mobile money because of the tax. You know, if, for example...
Is it practical to say that people will run away from mobile money?
You know, what you create gives a direction of the population. Now, population started with going directly to the agent and they receive cash directly. And now if you have to send like 1 million and above and you're sending to Kampala, I think it is even cheaper to travel to Kampala and and deliver,
and deliver the money rather than going to the village.
So it means the project is not success. It has to fail. So the whole thing, who plans that tax, is really not an economist to me.
Now, Chamogo University is known for bringing out economists and engineers, if I may say that. Should we do away with the mobile money and social media tax? Is it practical? Do we really make sense in our own ways if we say that this is a bad tax and we should do away with it?
To a higher extent, the tax is causing more harm. I would rather it gets scrapped off.
We leave it alone.
We go away from it.
So we have social media for free and move around
just like we had
free.
Been.
And then we go to government and ask for roads.
Exactly. Because the taxes that are being paid by us, the public people, is already being used in a way we don't understand.
We don't understand. Like what? For example, what things should be taxed?
There are better things to tax than mobile money or social media. Like, mean things which are not priority in life. Not like if you tax an MP, he will not feel it.
As Ugandans, we have our heritages and we have our cultures. Our cultures are very definite and they're very clear on some issues. So there are some things our communities should never tolerate at any point.
Are you comfortable looking at a nude photo on your phone, on WhatsApp?
Definitely, I'm not comfortable because I'm coming from this community I'm telling you about.
All right, let's head in for a short break. It's from IUIU, Let's Keep Our Morals Straight. But when we get back from that short break, we're going to be talking about Africa Now. It's one of the biggest hashtags, and since we are with young people, this is the time to talk about issues that affect us.